Ladies and gentlemen, up first for question and answer, we're gonna go ahead and let Kelsey talk to Chi Chi.
Oh, I need a microphone for this? You don't wanna do that. I'll swallow this whole overhead.
For those of you in the back, you couldn't hear that, but that was great.
Comparing Justin Trudeau and Putin's stance on foreign policy, who looks better shirtless riding a horse?
Who looks better shirtless riding a horse? Oh, for fuck's sake. Considering that Putin's a Russian prick, and he's fucked half the Eastern European women.
And men.
And she-males like me. I would love to say Putin just because he paid me last week. But with all the tabloids of Justin Trudeau and being shirtless all over BC, my home province. Anyone from BC? Woo! Oh, great. A lot of you stoners are here, or you're just not saying anything because there's no fucking stones. I'll have to go with Justin Trudeau. What?
Awesome answer. I agree.
Thank you very much, Chi Chi. All right. Up next, we're gonna let Raul talk to Electrocute.
Okay. Who am I talking to? Where? Oh, the Lady Gaga post. Okay. Question. Just to prepare everybody to fuck on the crowd. I'm a foreigner. I can barely read English. Just saying. I don't even know who these people are. Trump former Rob Ford and Boris Johnson all look like they're carved out of hand. Oh yeah, that's true, just fucking read the shit. Okay. Do you think there is any science behind a large plot of world domination by anthropomorphic hand? You got it? I have no idea what it just asked. Just say whatever answer I will be happy with, honey.
Oh, you literally asked the stupidest drag queen up here.
Oh, I like you! Hi!
So I'm gonna go in world peace.
Yes, queen! Oh my god, yes!
Buzzword.
I like your answer.
That was a good answer.
10 points to Lady Gaga.
10 points from Gryffindor. Pheromone, we're gonna let you talk to James. James, what do you gotta ask this bitch?
Alright, it's a traffic question, but it's not a traffic violation, so we should be good. So, who do you think is responsible for not having a turning light on the 10th Avenue going north where it connects to 14th Street, and how would you go about making a difference to solve this problem?
I'm gonna have to say that I blame myself.
I had a joke and it went away. Like, fuck, hold on, let's try that again.
I'm gonna have to say I blame myself because working the corner just a little bit further down, if there's a backup of traffic, I can't get to all the windows. I'm not a guy like cleaning windows, you know, like with a spray bottle. But I'm also gonna say April 25th because it's not too hot, it's not too cold.
Farrah's perfect date?
April 25th.
Alrighty, Logan, you get to ask Frigidaire a question.
This is probably the toughest question.
This is a tough question. Here, let me hand you the mic so you can prep yourself to answer.
It's rough.
Mine is tough.
Frigidaire?
Typical angry mom answer. Very good one. Very good. And we have a fifth question, and apparently we have a fifth contestant now. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Jasper.
But did he talk? That's what I want to know.
Think of asking
this. This, you are going to ask this lovely Jasper question.
Jasper. Recent polls have shown a fifth of Americans can't locate the U.S. on a world map. Why do you think that is?
I personally believe that U.S. Americans are unable to do so because some people out there in our nation don't have maps, and I believe that our education, like such as South Africa and Iraq, when we were like such as, and I believe that they should, our education over here in the U.S. should help the U.S., or should help South Africa, it should help the Iraq and the Asian countries, so we will be able to build up our future.
Thank you very much, Jasper. Contestant question and answer out of nowhere.